Impatient drivers. In addition, long lines everywhere. In the airports, pharmacies, grocery stores. Banks where everyone is eager to meet deadlines. In the midst of all the hustle and the bustle, everyone is getting ready for December 25th. Ashley, are you ready for Christmas? Amen. My beloved friends, whether we are in the crowds or not, perhaps at one time or another we have been there, trying to deal with sometimes the craziness of Christmas. And as we prepare for our Christmas celebrations, it is imperative that we do not leave out the guest of honor. As one writer stated, Christmas without Christ is a mess. So often we celebrate our parents, we celebrate our children, we celebrate our grandchildren, we celebrate our great-grandchildren, our spouses, our pastoral staff, we celebrate our family and friends. But my beloved friend, if we do not include the reason for the season, if we don't invite the reason for the celebration, we have truly missed this center of attraction. Can I get a witness? Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. We have missed the reason of why we should even be celebrating. For us as believers, December the 25th is not just a holiday. It is not just a time where we have our family dinners. It is not a time where we buy those special gifts or even support our local charities. But it is a time to celebrate the birth of our Savior Jesus the Christ. Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. Ask the neighbor, are you celebrating for the right reason? In the midst of all of our celebrations, please do not forget that Jesus is the reason for the season. Do I have a witness in the house? Come on and bless the Lord. Now some might say that this is not the day that Christ was born. Well, according to biblical research, no, I was not there, but I'm grateful that I believe this morning. I will not get caught up Canaan in the day or the hour or the second or the minute, but I am just grateful that he was born to bring hope, to bring joy, to bring love and peace into our world. Somebody give the Lord some praise. Not only for this life, but the life yet to come. Some folks had it wrong. Many thought that John the Baptist was the Savior of the world. But John made it clear of his purpose. John calls for a change in lifestyle that reflects the genuineness of our repentance. Tell your neighbor, there gotta be a change in your life. He was making it clear in your way of living, in your priorities, in your commitment, as well as your personal relationship, there ought to be a change. Passion for peace and justice. He made it clear we gotta learn how to have acts of compassion that will not only affect us, but affect others. Somebody ought to say thank you. John's preaching is a prophetic warning against the coming judgment of God. A call to justice and a call to compassion. How in the world can we say that we are Christians when we don't know the definition of justice? How can we say that we are men and women of God, but then we don't treat our brothers and sisters with acts of compassion? Amen? Amen. So, my beloved friends, we ought to be mindful that John was reminding them that Jesus the Christ, the coming Messiah, was coming. But in order for the Messiah to be received, we must make preparation. So what should we learn from this passage? 3 points this morning. First of all, we must be like John and tell the world that we do not have an identity crisis, but we know who we are and whose we are. Amen? And as the John made it clear, I am not the Savior. I am not the one who offers forgiveness. I am not the one that was born in the mark in the city of David as the Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord. not the one who was born in a lowly manger. I am not the one who had brought hope, love, and joy, and peace to all humanity. No, I'm not the one. John was making it clear that he was only the forerunner of Christ, preparing the way of the Lord. John was making it clear, Ken, I know my place. I know who I am. I know my purpose. And sometimes, Ken, we forget who we are. We forget our purpose. Because, don't miss this point, we are so busy trying to do everybody else's work and our own go back. Everybody's been there before. But John made it clear, I am not the Savior. Amen. Tell you that I know who I am. Don't say it like you mean it. If you really know who you are in Christ, you ought to give the Lord some praise. Come on and bless the Lord. Hey, there's a neighbor. When you see me singing, don't get it confused. It's not about me. When you see me preaching, don't get it confused. It's not about me. When you see me praying, don't get it twisted. It's not about me. But it's all about God. It's all about Jesus and the Holy Spirit. Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. We ought to be grateful that we are grateful for the kingdom. Can I get a witness? Do you know who you are this morning? Can I get a witness? I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that I know I'm a child of God. And whose we are. Secondly, we must be like John and know our purpose. Tell you that, you gotta know your purpose. John was sent to prepare the way of the Lord. He was a voice crying out in the wilderness, preparing ye the way of the Lord. He was a voice encouraging even the tax collectors, the people of the city, to repent, but not just to repent, but to change their ways. Amen. Pray there was a neighbor with repentance come change. Amen. Don't get quiet on me on that. See, a lot of us are crying, Lord, I'm sorry. But then we don't want to do the other part. We don't want to make a change in our lives. But how many of you know there ought to be a change in the way we live? There ought to be a change in the way we communicate one with another. There ought to be a change in the way we love one another. There ought to be a change in the way we give. There ought to be a change in the way we serve. He was challenging them to change not for a season, but for eternity. Can you give us a name? Yes, there's a time and season for all things. But don't give God just a season. How many of you know God deserves all of our time? He was challenging his audience to understand repentance was a lifestyle with fruit that would be pleasing in the sight of God. He was challenging them to let their light shine in their way of living. Pastor, everybody, is the light shining this morning? Can I get a witness? Has it ever been somebody see Christ living inside of you? As the neighbor to neighbor, can somebody see Christ living inside of you this morning? He was challenging them even to make a change with their priorities. Because sometimes our priorities, church, are all messed up. He was challenging them even in their commitments to make a change. Because see, sometimes we'll say, Lord, if you get me off my bed of affliction, Lord, if you raise me up again, if you do this for mama, if you do this for daddy, Lord, I promise you, I'll do X, Y, Z. And we still won't honor the commitment. But how many of you know, in spite of our slowfulness, in spite of our shortcomings, that God is still faithful? If you believe that, you ought to give the Lord some praise. John is making it clear. He was preparing them for the one that was to come and to bring salvation into their lives. In the midst of this Christmas celebration, I simply ask this morning, do you know the purpose for this season? Do you know the purpose of our Savior being born in a lonely manger? Do you know the purpose of our Savior giving hope for all humanity? Do you know the purpose of our Savior not being born in Marriott? Not being born, glory be to God, in Roper? Not being born at MUSC or even college in the regional? Do you know why he was born in a lonely manger? To teach us about humility. And to teach us, glory be to God, hallelujah, that if we're going to be servants of the Most High God, we got to learn how to walk in humbleness. We got to learn how to walk in humility. We got to learn how to walk where the Savior honors us. Somebody ought to say thank you. Do you know the purpose this morning of our Savior's love? The joy, peace that extends even beyond December 25th. Do you know the purpose of why our Savior came into the world? The way he lived, the way he lived. The way he walked, the way he walked. The way he talked, the way he talked. The way he taught, the way he did. The way he even died. Do we understand? Sometimes we get caught up in the day and the hour. But what really matters to Christ is knowing that he was born in our lives. Amen? Finally, John teaches us that the gift of this season is for all humanity. Amen? Are we glad about that? Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I don't care where you've been in life. Say it like you mean it. Say, neighbor, I don't care where we have been in life. We got a Savior who loves us. See, some of us think that we've been saints all of our lives. Can I get a witness? But tell your neighbor, you haven't always been a saint. I'm going to be a God saved. Can I get a witness? You aren't always born again. We were not always filled with the Holy Ghost. Can I get a witness? But how many of you know we've made some mistakes in life? We've fallen short of the glory of God. By faith be unto God. Thanks be unto God. When the world said no, how many of you know Jesus said yes? When the world said I'm passing you aside, aren't you glad this morning that we have a Savior who said I love you in spite of? Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. But everybody else said, you don't belong here. But God said, my child, you welcome me. Somebody ought to say thank you. How many of you know God loves all of us? Somebody ought to say thank you. Believe it's a man. Believe it's a woman. We are passed out every time. But I'm so glad that I got a Savior. Can I get a witness? When I'm burning down, he is there. When my head is against the wall, he's there. When I don't know which way to turn, can I get a witness? Somebody said he was there all the time. Somebody ought to give him glory. Tell your neighbors and neighbor, he was there. When the world said no, Jesus said yes. Do I have a witness in the house? Come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Anybody ever been passed to the side? If you've ever been passed to the side, just say, Lord, I thank you. But everybody else left me alone. Your love was right there. Do I have a witness in the house? I'm going to give it glory. Hallelujah. 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 I'm going to bless the Lord in this place. Say, I'm so grateful. Somebody loves you. Don't play with this story. But if you're grateful that he loves you, you ought to give him some glory in this world. Hallelujah. 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 Now tell somebody in the sanctuary he loves you. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid. Some of y'all living at your neighbor like a deer in headlights. But say, neighbor, in spite of my condition, he loves me anyhow. I want to bless the Lord in this way. Hallelujah. Anybody pray for this Lord that he loves you? Hallelujah. Anybody made a mistake this morning? Say, Lord, I thank you for another chance. Can I be a witness? Anybody in here ever been down? If you've ever been down, say, Lord, I thank you for raising me up, for lifting me up. But he gives it for all. All be glad about it. Come on and bless the name of the Lord and be blessed. See, John was dealing with some folk who thought they had it all together. Anybody ever dealt with folk like that? Can I get a witness? But how many of you know it does not matter where we fall? Thank you, Jesus. That God reminds us you are still in need of my grace. You're still in need of my mercy. They lived all kinds of lives. They were persons who practiced religiosity. Amen. I want you to make sure you understand that. So religiosity is when we do things over and over and over. Amen. But how many of you know God is not looking for religious folk? But God is looking for persons flowing in a God that are Christians. Can I get a witness? That are born again believers. Can I get a witness? Somebody ought to get a voice of praise. They lack the understanding of stewardship. They lack the understanding of agape love. They lack the glory be to God, what it truly means to even be in peace one with another. How in the world do we shout every Sunday and yet we cause more conflict than the next? Amen. And I know conflict can be good, but sometimes we just love foolishness. But as John was teaching, he was telling them to get it right. He welcomed and all and proclaimed the good news to all. And I say the teacher thus, he came to bring hope, love, joy, and salvation. Not for some relegators, not for a few, not for the upper class of those who live on one side versus another. Not for the highly sophisticated or even the educated. Not for the social club or even what we call the cliques. Amen. Don't act like we don't have it in life. But how many of you know he came to bring eternal joy, eternal hope, eternal love, peace through God's plan of redemption? Therefore, this is why Jesus is the reason for the season. It is wrapped up in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believeth in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Somebody love, friends, this morning. Hallelujah. Jesus is the reason for the season. I don't care what other folk may say, but he was the one born in a lowly manger. We all love our comfort. We all love the finer things in life. But how many of you know, glory be to God, our Savior teaches us, hallelujah, that there is a more excellent way. He teaches us this season, and it should overflow into every season of our lives. We celebrate love one to another, but how many of you know love should not end December the 25th? Amen. Hope should not end December the 25th. Joy, peace should not end December the 25th. But if we're going to live a full life, a Christian life, one that God will be pleased with, these tenets need to be a part of our daily living. And my friends, when we do these things, we're not only able to honor God, but we're able to honor our brothers and sisters that God has given unto us. So in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, it does not matter what somebody else says. You must know for yourself that he is the reason for the season. Somebody ought to bless his name. If you're able to stand to your feet today, hallelujah. Now I want you just to go and witness to somebody as the Holy Spirit speaks. And remind that person that Jesus is the reason for the season. Don't be afraid.